Welcome to the Land of Goshen International Churches with Pastor Franklin Ngali. We join that service already in progress. Here's Pastor Ngali.
Yeah, praise the Lord. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, Lord, we give you the glory tonight. We give you the adoration tonight. We worship you. We bow before you, the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. Blessed be your name, in the mighty name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Lord, we thank you for the privilege, for the opportunity you've given us to come before your presence tonight. Thank you, Lord Jesus, for the teachings. I surrender my spirit, soul, and body unto you, God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit, as it to speak through me in the mighty name of Jesus. I stand upon the rock, and as the Lord Jesus, I bind every cohort of hell. I come against you tonight by the blood of Jesus. I release the angelic host, loyal to the Most High God, to take their strategic positions all around this sanctuary in the mighty name of Jesus. And the heavens get open to answer to the needs of the children of the Most High God. Holy Spirit, I surrender my intellect to you. I surrender my tongues to you. Talk to your people in the mighty name of Jesus. Yes, today again, we shall be discussing something on causes. The other time we were saying something about the soul, and I told about the difference between the spirit, the soul, and the body, and their interconnections, how it affects our existence and our relationship with the Lord, which is very essential. Then today I'm going to talk a little bit upon the causes, the situation we happen to find ourselves upon the earth. It's just like when you read your history book, the Lord is quite open. That's why, you see, I tell people, you see, about religion. We Christians are not in a religious group. We are not religionists. There's a difference between Christianity and religion. Religion is man's own way to God, finding a way to worship God or whatever, or his own God. My great-great-grandfathers in those days, they did it. They call the name of their father. They go to the bush. They go to the stream. They stay by the side. They worship. They do this thinking that they're worshiping God. That's what you call religion. Man's own way to God. But God's own way to man is the Lord sending his own son, the Lord Jesus, to come to the earth, to be with us here for 33 years and prove himself. And even before that time, in the book of Isaiah 9, he made it very clear that unto us a son shall be given. A child is born, a son is given. And the government is going to be upon his shoulder. And his name shall be called Emmanuel. And he will be in charge of the government. So that is Christianity. So we are wrong this time you say my religion. No, your religion is your own man, a way, finding a way to worship God. No. It's only through Jesus Christ that you can worship the Lord. The Lord, the most mighty God. That's what I want us to know. So now we're not going on the subject of these days, calling about the causes. You should remember that when God created the heaven and earth, when the first human being that God created, Adam and Eve, was at the Garden of Eden, well, that's the paradise. It was wonderful, it was great, everything was moving fine. Until when the devil that was driven out came to deceive Adam and Eve. And then deceive them out of the Garden of Eden, of the paradise where they ought to be and enjoying the presence of God every evening. They now come and do what? And now they were driven down out and they came down upon the earth. And then the Lord placed a curse upon Adam, upon Eve, our forefathers. They were the people of mothers and fathers. They were the only two human beings that were created. And through them, regeneration began to expound up to this very day. But a curse that was placed upon them because of the sin that they have committed by disobeying the word of God and carrying the word of Satan, which is a former angel Lucifer. As also Lucifer was also driven out, and then the heaven was closed, and he just stayed not very far from us here in the skies, and we'll be doing a lot of stuff. So now, curse now came unto man. And from that time, not only that Adam and Eve was cursed, the earth which we live now was also cursed, that the ground cannot yield its full fruit unto us. So the ground was locked off. The air, everything was locked off under curse. God gave it to that. God gave that curse on them. It's not that he just started. So we in this generation, it is not a new thing. It has been generational. You could see that when God was pronouncing the curse upon the woman, he said when you are laboring to get a child, it's going to be in pains. It is happening today. It's the same thing. He now tell the man, he say, you will till the ground and you will swear before you eat. It's still happening today. It's from the word of God. It is here. It's not that probably as something happened to us. No. It is that same word that was spoken that is still in existence today. The curse that's still in existence today. And then after the Lord has looked and looked and looked, he said, what am I going to do? These are my own image. I'm going to get them back. The angel that committed the same offense was never got back. But yet, he now gave a prophecy of Christ coming to rescue us and redeem us so that we can be able to come back to where we used to be in those times. And then we now came to live under the curse upon the earth. That you are a Christian does not mean you are exempted from the curse. The only way you can be exempted from the curse, thank God that we are at the time of Jesus Christ. When he has come, we say, I give unto you the power to tread upon the serpent, upon the scorpions, and nothing shall by any means hurt you. But even the very current Bible that we are reading today, when you now go to the book of Genesis, you will see the whole thing that the Lord has said concerning these curses. Even in Deuteronomy 28, from 14 down to 60, you will see about the curse of infirmity and everything that the Lord spoke is still in existence today. It has not gone. But then, we now been exempted because Jesus Christ has come to redeem us from the curse of the law. Genesis, it's not a Genesis. That's Jesus has come to redeem us from the curse of the law. Because curse is he that hangeth on a tree. That's Galatians 3:13 to 14. When you go to Galatians 3:13 to 14, Jesus now came to redeem us from the curse of the law. Because curse is he that hangeth on a tree. So he hangeth on the cross because of me and because of you. So that we can have authority. Why? He says so that the blessings of Abraham will become ours. Because originally it was ours at the Garden of Eden. That is at the paradise. It was ours. But because of what happened, the Satan robbed us all of our rights. And then we become like a slave unto him. And then, one thing again before we go further, I want us to learn. The demons that are in charge, are responsible, and then be implementing this curse all over the places. Or it doesn't matter whether you are white or green or black or red. In the four corners of the world, everywhere you have, upon the earth, even the sea, you still have the demons everywhere. But then, people are not actually very much aware of what is going on upon their lives. They think that once you get born again and you are a Christian, that's all. Why is this thing happening to me? But there is something that you have to do for these things not to happen to you. Because the demons that continue to enforce these forces, they are more than the human beings upon the earth. By 1,000 times, they are more. Why are they more? They are dismembered bodies. You remember during the time of Noah? When God came down, he could not find any righteous man except Noah and the family. And then the iniquity grew and grew and grew and grew up. It grew to the extent that he can no longer condone it. What did he do? He now began to tell Noah, say, you have to build an ark. That when you build an ark, I will tell you what to do. And Noah, hearing the voice of God, built an ark. You understand what God was saying? He built an ark according to God's description. And after he built an ark, the people of the world were busy doing what they are doing, drinking and they're fornicating, doing a lot of killing, destroying, taking themselves to be God themselves, without control. And then Noah built that ark. And at the completion of the ark, God telling how to arrange it, how to bring every animal, species of every animal, he and his family become the species of men. And then all animals were in that very ark. And they were all contained there. And now God now caused a rain to come down upon the earth. Severe rain for 40 days and 40 nights. So what happened? The whole earth was filled with rain continuously for 40 days and 40 nights. Serious rain. And then, remember that both the humanity that were upon the earth, they were sunk, they were destroyed by the rain. Not that they were destroyed. Their flesh were destroyed. Because you can't destroy the spirit. That's what's going to stand the judgment. So now, their bodies become dismembered from their spirit. The flesh, I mean, the fraud wash out, what they call, their flesh. And then, their body, their dismembered body, the spirit, remains in every part of the world. And when it got dried, when the whole earth now got dried, what happened? After another 40 or 100 and something days, and then the earth now came down. And one thing I want to let you know is that, you see, the ark of the covenant that raised up Noah and the family to safety is also the same ark that destroyed these elements. So that's whom God is. He's able to rescue me, he's able to rescue you. But he's also able to do what? To destroy every elemental force is contrary to his will. Is that same God? He does it just like two-edged sword. He knows one when you are good. He knows also when you have turned your back unto him. So lay that aside. And then, these dismembered bodies, they are all over the place. But in any part of the world you go, you will see them. Because they were covered and under the sea, they are there. So now they are looking for bodies to occupy. And now because of the Bible saying my people are perishing for lack of knowledge. Then the Lord said, okay, my Lord's son, I'm going to send my son to go and teach the people so that they will know. And that's why Jesus has to come here to stay 33 years with us. Teaching us about the kingdom. Because there's nobody that would have done that. Nobody would have talked of salvation. Who would have taught us that? Jesus came down. And then was here, going from place to place, place to place. Now raise up the apostles, our brothers like Elijah and the rest of them, to begin to teach about the kingdom of God. That there is hope for me and there is hope for you. Thank God we are in that generation. But I believe that as we are in that generation, we should be able to make use of that generation seriously. What I'm telling you is not fiction. It is real. Whether you believe it or not, it's going to come to pass. When you give your life to Christ, it's not only giving your life to Christ. Giving your life to Christ means knowing God through his word and applying it unto yourself. And you begin to manifest God's glory. It's not enough to carry the Bible from place to place and people say, yes, he's a Christian. Of course, when they see the Bible, they call you a Christian. But do you really understand what is in the word? Are you applying it to your life and situations? Because that's what it means. Apply the word of God. It's an apply for most of us when we are sent to school. We went to read medicine. When we come back, we begin to apply the knowledge to treat people. We read engineering, which I did, of course. We came back. I worked as a mechanical engineer. I was in the workshops most of the time. Fabrication, steel plants where I work. I was doing these things practically because that is exactly what I was taught in my five years in the university. But it is in this, when I see Christians, they have the word of God in their hand, they carry it as a decoration. They never put it into practice. How can it yield a fruit? It can't yield a fruit. And they say, I am suffering from this cause. The solution is here in the world. He said, ye shall know the truth, and the truth shall set you free. It is the truth you know and apply. That's what sets you free. It is the truth you know about success that sets you free from poverty. It is the truth you know about healing that sets you free from sickness. Because you run from it. Like as at this time, we are on this pandemic everywhere. Every time we are praying, who are we praying to? To the Lord our God that made the heavens and the earth. We are praying from the sincerity of our heart. And when we are praying to the Lord, what are we now doing at the same time? We must know that the same mouth we use in praising to the Lord our God shouldn't be the same mouth we're going to use in cursing people everywhere. No! You must discipline your mouth. When you discipline your mouth to speak what the word, he said, let the righteous say it is well because of what the Lord has done. You can't use one mouth to come to the church and kneel and pray. And as soon as you are going out down there, you are cursing people, you are doing a lot of havoc. You are committing fornication and adultery, and you think that your word is going to stand. No. That's exactly what the Spirit of the Lord is telling us. That's why Christ came. He redeemed us from the curse of the law, breaking the yoke of sin that we committed and our forefathers committed, so that we can see the light, and the light is in the word. And what am I telling us today, children of God? That when we read the word, we have to go into what it means. Because the Bible says upon Mount Zion there shall be deliverance. Deliverance from sickness, deliverance from death, deliverance from infirmity, deliverance from evil of the world. Because the world is full of the world. But until you go into the scriptures, you now begin to see the word of God. Because the Bible says, search the scriptures, for in there you shall find what? Eternal life. It is written here. It's not in heaven. It's here with me and you. It's only when you begin to go through the scriptures and you are baptized in the Holy Spirit, and the Spirit will begin to open your inner eyes so that you can begin to know the reality of the kingdom of God. Because already it's free. You don't need to pay anything to be born again. To be born again is to look, take, wash away your former body, your original body with which you came from the womb or from wherever we come from. Especially people from Africa and other parts of it, they worship everything worshipable. That was a great sin and iniquity. They have been visiting from generation to generation, keep them in poverty forever. Why? Because they've never got the word of God to open up their inner eye with their spirit man, for them to see that they were made to be signs and wonders before the Lord. They not just yield themselves to their little small gods. But what I'm telling us today, that's why you see people falling sick. A lot of people can't have a child, too sick back. Barrenness comes from behind. I mean other generations before you. And because you have not done anything differently, you still begin to do what? Suffer what they suffered in their days. The essence of being in Christ is that when you are baptized by the Holy Spirit, the Spirit of God will open up your inner eyes. We give you visions and dreams according to the book of Joel, so that you can see the past 1,000 or 2,000 years ago behind you. And then you can begin to correct those things that your forefathers have done that will make you to move forward in the kingdom of God. Righteousness. The Bible says, seek ye the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all other things shall be added unto you. Why I'm talking this, but look, when I'm organizing the faith clinic, a lot of stories I hear from different men and women and from different people. Stories. And it's true what they've gone through. I say, you don't need to go through this. The Lord has provided, has given provision for that in the world. They say they don't know. Deliverance is there for you. Only if you can come and accept Jesus as your Lord and Savior from the inner heart, not from your flesh, from your spirit man. Because for God is a spirit, and they that should worship him in truth and in spirit. Not in life, not in your flesh. You don't worship me for people to say I'm a Christian, no. But your character, your attitude, whatever, will show that you're a Christian. And God will begin to open, give you the keys of the kingdom. Begin to open your life. Begin to open what is actually belonging to you. He said, I have not called you to serve me in vain. When you are serving the Lord, and you know, I am telling you, your doors will be open. You can never be hungry. You can never lack. Why? Because he is the one that created the heavens and earth, and the whole thing that is therein. He said, I am the God that giveth thee power to eat wealth and power to make wealth. According to the book of 3 John 2. Is that same God? Wealth is not where the way the people of the world are making their wealth. No. The wealth that God gives to you, he said it blesses and he added no sorrow. You don't go out to kill man in order to make money is not much of that wealth. When you get the money that God gives to you, you are tithing, you are doing what you ought to do. I am telling you, the gates of hell can prevail against you. The devil will come and not find anything in you. The demons will come, they will not find anything in you. But today, a lot of people are in the church and here they go into secret societies, contrary to the will of God, doing a lot of sacrifice with even human beings and a lot of things. And then when they come out, the people of the world say, he's very rich, he has billions. But they don't know how it comes about. That he's joking with his own life. He's selling his own life and destiny. When he leaves this earth, where is he going to go? He's going to the pit of hell. He said, the Bible said, what does it profit a man after enjoying the whole of this world? And they will do what? Lost his soul. The soul is even lost already. Those things that he has been so much proud of, they will all go because he's going to leave them on the earth. They are not going with him. But you that decide to follow your God, you that decide to follow Jesus and the Holy Spirit, you that say beside God that there's no other one, you will enjoy and you will go to the full age that God has given unto you. And then you, even in your present, your children and generation that have been generated from you, because you have broken the curse that comes before you, then those people that come after you will not suffer the effect of that curse again. A lot of people suffer from barrenness. They don't have a child. It's not that God made them not to have a child. It's the curse that's on the ground that they have not broken. A lot of you cannot have steady job. Today they walk. The next tomorrow they are off. Why? Because of their mouth and a lot of things that follow that follows them. The demon that follows them. You remember when in the book of Mark 5, when you go to the book of Mark 5 and also you go to the book of Ezekiel 18:20, and also you go to the book of Luke 28. When Christ was there in a village, and then he saw the man at the womb, at the tomb, the burial ground. And then, when Jesus came, want to look at that man, he want to set him free there from, he had been there for many years. He'd been crazy, cutting his body, a human being. And then when the Lord wants to command, the demons to get out, then the demons were begging him, say, where are we going to go? When you send us out, where are we going to go? Then he answered, he said, please permit us so that we can go into the swine to do what? To find a place. And then the Lord said, okay, come out of this man. They came out of that man. The Bible says about 2,000 of the demons inside one man. And then they rush into the swine and they rush into the sea. And the man was become whole. You can see, if 2,000 demons can live inside one man, you can know what that means. The man was living in the burial ground, cutting his cells, so day and night he can't sleep. And he doesn't know what happened. But when Jesus now set him free, he now started following Jesus. Now become a deliverance minister. You see what is going on? Because if you refuse to give your life to Christ, the demons will take over. Small, you steal. From stealing, you kill. From killing, you are in jail. From here, what is going to happen? You end up the same thing that man would have been. Thank God he met Jesus. The demons are looking for a house to inhabit. Those demons that was killed, that was, dismembered during the time of Noah, they are still on the earth. They are looking for a place to occupy because they are more than the people we have on the earth now. Maybe we have like 6 million, according to them, or I don't know whether billion, 1 or 4 billion people upon the earth. They are 10 times more than that. So looking for a body to inhabit. When they inhabit your body, you begin the spirit of lies, the spirit of stealing will come. From stealing, the spirit of, look, a lot of this demonic spirit will come. Not only lies, not only stealing, even when you don't need to steal, you steal. When you don't need to lie, you lie. When you don't need fornication, we follow. Adultery, we follow. Killing, we follow. A lot of them, we follow. You then begin to join all the demonic societies. And when you join them, thinking that that's where it is, you are then now begin to take you to make different sacrifices. You are selling not only yourself, but the future that's coming behind you. When you have children, they are taking that same blood in you. They will do the same thing you do. So your generation eventually is already cursed, even when they have not been given birth to. Why? Because of the work of your hand. If you are so a righteous man, the same thing, you have said the generation of the righteous shall be blessed. You are doing what the word of God has said. The same thing your generation coming behind you, they will never feel any curse. And they follow the same pattern because you have laid it down. So, children of God, as I'm talking to us this evening, I am talking to us from the deliverance point of view. That many things we are going through, we are not supposed to be going through. If we read the scripture, because the Bible says, read the scripture, for in there you will have eternal life. You will find eternal life. Everything we need appertaining to life and godliness is in the word of God. This is the word of God that creates every other thing upon the heaven and earth. Every religion that you see, they're from the word of God. Remember what I said in the beginning, that religion is God's man's own way to God. But Christianity is God's own way to man by sending the Son, the Lord Jesus Christ, to us. That's why they call us Christians. We are not religionists. A lot of Christians will say, my religion is Roman Catholic. No! You are a Christian, a body of Christ. The soul spirit of God is in you. The image of God is in you. They say, man, God made man in his own image and likeness. That's whom we are. We are not two. That's what I'm letting us to know, children of God. As I'm talking to us tonight, open up our ears. Open up our eyes. We're here. and God can still forgive us anytime. Look back to your generation. What has happened? It can still be amended in your day. God has created us for a time such as this to be upon the earth. All those things for many generations can still be amended. That's the way you come to a ministry, the deliverance ministry. When you undergo the faith clinic, then we'll be able to ascertain all these things, know where to start from. And then the Lord Jesus through us will start deliverance for you. That's exactly what I'm letting you know. We are here for the glory of the living God. And I want us, children of God, at this time such as this, it calls for absolute attention to the world. It calls for what? Absolute attention to the world. When this pandemic is not like it's just the first. It has happened in Israel. It was more severe than what we're seeing. It was, look, quick. In 3-4 days, the whole thing was happening. They have no way to teach them what to do in order to be saved. But the people in the land of Goshen, according to Exodus 8:20, he said there's no swan or fly that will touch them. That's why Moses was instructed to sprinkle the blood 7 times at the lintel of the door, and every man has to do it in his house. And they obeyed the word of God. So what am I telling you? Today, the same pandemic is coming just in a very light way the way it has come. If you have not given your life to Christ, you must. It's a law. It's a law. And when you give your life to Christ, then we begin to teach you exactly what is going to save you and your generations. The pandemic will not be a part of you. Impossible. Because the Holy Spirit is living on inside of you. The anointing is enveloping you. The power of God has covered you. He sanctifies the air you breathe, because God is the one that manufactures the air. It's not man. It's not science. It's omniscience, which is God himself, that produces it. I'm not telling you not to put your mouth. You must obey the rule of the law. He said we must obey the government, for they are there to give us peace. When they make a law, obey it. But at the same time, the major one is what? Is the word of God. Read it every day. Tell the Holy Spirit to teach you. He will teach you exactly. Let me pray before we round up. Father Lord, we thank you. We bless you. As I commit your children unto you at the sound of my voice, let the word of God go deep into their heart and possess them in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Sanctify them. I say, as they go out, Father, let them be sanctified. Let the air they're going to breathe be sanctified. Let the environment be sanctified. They will never have any transmission of this virus in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. We cover each and every soul with the blood of Jesus. The soul that is to come and the soul that's already. All those who's already suffering, Holy Spirit, go and lay hand upon them and give them divine healing right now in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. So that your name will always be glorified. You are the great I am that I am. You are the healer of humanity. Blessed be your name. In the precious name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, I've prayed. And everybody say, Amen. I say, good night, everybody. Praise the Lord. Amen.
You have been listening to Land of Goshen International Churches with Pastor Franklin Ngali. If you'd like to contact them, their phone number is 212-470-2804. Again, that number is 212-470-2804.
Yeah, that's good.